in the Nuba Mountains, in Brunei, in Darfur, we are not in post-conflict situation. We are in situations of active conflict. However, we need the tools of transitional justice to prepare for the post-conflict situation. This is the source of this confusion. For example, a very good example is documentation. We need to document what's happening today so that when there is a day where we can have justice, we can put our case to a court of justice, we can put our case to a commission of claims saying that my house was burned, I lost a bicycle and a mattress, and I lost, you know, or my son was killed, or I was tortured and detained. If we don't have the documentation today, we cannot claim justice for the victims. If we do not document today who is committing these crimes, we cannot take them to court, ICC or local courts, when these courts are reformed. Because the courts of today are not equipped to realize justice. Not at all. You know, there is a special court for Darfur, there is a special court, a special prosecutor, there are investigators, they are doing nothing. And the last prosecutor actually resigned because he was unable to do anything. You know, and the one before him was resigned by the government because it was becoming too embarrassing. After 3 years of existence, they didn't come up with one case of human rights violations in Darfur. So this is not a normal situation. This is a situation of ongoing conflict, of ongoing mass violations. But to get anywhere with the idea of justice, we really need to be serious and systematic about documentation. Now, each one of us has a bit of the reality, has a bit of the documents. And that's why the efforts that are led by the group against torture in Sudan, the Sudan Human Rights Network, are quite commendable and really need to be encouraged. Whatever bit of information we have, we need to contribute into this stream, strengthening the documentary base of their work so that one day we are able to claim justice and to put pressure and to expose those who are responsible for these crimes. I think this, you know, this is an essential part because, you know, I'm not talking about today. You know, I know that there are killings occurring today in Blue Nile. What I am worried about is how to document what's happening today. It's not just hearsay. I want evidence that is presentable before a court of law. This is not easy to put together, but it is possible to put together. You see, it is possible, and I can guarantee you there are people who are working on it for the Nuba Mountains, for Blue Nile, for Darfur, and for Khartoum. You know, there are so many networks that we need to really do more than whatever is happening now in very difficult circumstances. Thank you.